Hey, you action figure enthusiasts out there, JC here with another TNI news video. Now this one's going to be a pretty quick update video. I just wanted to share the highlights from today. Today is the first day of two international conventions going on where Hasbro is in attendance. So we've got the MCM London Comic Con and then the 2018 Comic Con Paris, and Hasbro is at both of these conventions. So at the London Comic Con, Hasbro had a couple of Marvel Legend reveals in their at their booth to show off to people. Their actual panel at that convention isn't until Sunday. It'll be 8 a.m. Eastern Time is when the Hasbro Star Wars and Marvel panel will be at the London Comic Con. So I do expect there'll be a few more reveals for those products then. But they did have a couple new things out today when the convention opened. So for Marvel Legends, they revealed that they're doing a Puma figure. If I remember correctly, he's a Native American who basically has the ability to turn into a puma and has like the abilities of a puma. And I think he's like a mercenary type character, if I remember correctly. I haven't looked him up, and it's been a long time since I read the original issues that he appeared in. But I believe he's like a mercenary type character and will often have, you know, conflict with Spider-Man. But I don't think it was really like a true villain like we generally see. So besides that, we also got a look at they're doing a six-armed Spider-Man. So, you know, Spider-Man at one point in the comics grows multiple arms like a spider. So they're actually doing an action figure of that. Now this one, I don't know, looks okay, but articulation is a bit limited. Has no ab crunch, which I guess is understandable since he's got like six arms and everything. But I definitely have seen some of you complaining about the articulation on that one. And some of you have also commented it kind of looks like the mold from the Amazing Spider-Man 2 figure. I'm not entirely sure about that, but it could be. But I believe both of those figures are going to be part of the Kingpin Build-A-Figure wave. They also had on hand the Night Thrasher figure from New Warriors that we first saw at New York Comic Con. So that figure was also on hand and out on display at the London Comic Con. Then switching over to the Paris Comic Con, the Hasbro panel was today at the Paris Comic Con, and they did have a couple of reveals there. So on Star Wars and Transformer fronts, there wasn't a whole lot revealed at this panel. They announced a 6-inch Black Series Padme Amidala from the Episode 2 movie, which looks pretty good. That's my favorite version of Padme, so I'm glad they're doing that. And then for the Vintage Collection, they announced a Chewbacca figure, which I believe is from the original trilogy, so that one's not terribly exciting. That was really it for Star Wars. And then for Transformers, they announced some new Studio Series figures with Optimus Prime, Jetfire, and Bone Crusher. So if you like those movie Studio Series figures, we're getting some more figures for that line. And then for Marvel Legends probably had the most reveals at the panel. So first of all, they announced that they're doing, for the upcoming Avengers wave, they're doing Loki. So we still don't know how this full wave is going to play out. Probably the Beta Ray Bill is going to be in this wave. Probably the Hercules figure is going to be in this wave. So we'll just have to wait and see. But Loki is announced for an upcoming Avengers assortment. Classic Loki from the comic books. So I think that one's pretty cool. And then they also basically gave us the entire lineup for the Captain Marvel wave. So we'd seen the movie figures from this wave. Amazon leaked them out several weeks ago. That's going to have the Captain Marvel figure. It's going to have Star Force Commander. It's going to have Talos. They're calling him Talos. I think that's the Skrull. And then Nick Fury, a young Nick Fury. And then they also finally announced that the Genis Veil that they first showed off at San Diego Comic-Con, the comic book version, is going to be part of this wave. And then the final figure that we did not know about until today was Grey Gargoyle. So this is a classic Iron Man villain, and he touches you and you turn into stone, basically. And he's going to be part of this wave as well. And then, of course, the Build-A-Figure, as we already knew, is going to be that Kree Sentry that they first showed. I think it was at the unboxing convention. So that rounds out the Captain Marvel wave, which will be out early next year. I'm probably most excited for the Grey Gargoyle. I always like that character. Again, I know him as the classic Iron Man villain as opposed to Captain Marvel, but I think he's definitely a cool villain to have. And I'm pretty excited for the Loki figure too. I've wanted a good classic Loki for some time, so I'm pretty happy about that one. The Puma, I think, is cool. The six-armed Spider-Man, I could probably do without if you're one of these guys that like to collect all the different variations of Spider-Man. I think that'll be cool for you. But that one, you know, not nearly as excited for. I definitely like the Night Thrasher, as I mentioned at New York Comic Con. I love Night Thrasher, and that's one I'm definitely looking forward to. And overall, I would say that Spider-Man wave, that Kingpin Build-A-Figure wave, is a very solid one, probably one of the best overall waves that we've seen for the coming year. Okay, so that's it. I'd love to hear your thoughts on everything we talked about. So again, on Sunday, just keep in mind that there is another panel at the London Comic Con, and so we should probably get some more reveals. I don't know how many. I doubt we'll get any reveals tomorrow. I can't swear it, but I doubt it. They'll probably hold anything else they've got left for Sunday at the panel, but we'll just have to wait and see. If there are any reveals tomorrow, we'll be sure to post about it on Marvelous News. And then again, there will be a panel on Sunday, which we'll be bringing you guys coverage of. So let me know what you guys think about everything that's been revealed so far. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Oh, and also next weekend, there's another convention that Hasbro is going to be at. So we'll get even more reveals next weekend. But anyway, let me know your thoughts on everything that was revealed so far. And, you know, as always, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment, like the video, and follow me on my Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram accounts. Also, be sure to head over to TNI and Marvelous News. We're doing contests over there where we're giving away $100 store credits to places like Big Bad Toy Store. And until next time, guys, I'll catch you later.